Okay, so 13 years, is that what you said?
Yeah, 12.
So 12 years sober, 12 years sober, and you're on HIV meds. What message could you send to somebody about being on HIV meds? Because you hear a lot of people say, oh, they're going to kill me. They're going to make me sick. Do you think HIV meds actually help you live longer?
Well, and I can only say from my own experience,
okay,
what it's done for me.
Okay.
You know, so far it's helped mine. So, okay, you know, what works for me may not work for everybody.
Right.
People might find alternative medication.
Right.
So you find what will work for you.
Okay.
And so far my medications work. I've had to change only once.
Okay.
And the medication I changed to just picked right up where the other one left. In fact, it's better.
Okay.
So I was on something that I should have stopped a long time ago, but they found out and we changed it, and now it's better.
Okay.
You know, along with the other things I have going on, chronic illnesses. So far, the HIV is not really my problem.
Okay, so it's not something that you worry about?
No.
Okay.
You know, I work on it, trying to take care of myself.
Okay.
Trying to eat as good as I can, as right as I can.
Right.
And trying to take care of myself, you know, the best I can.
Right.
So that's all I can do.
Well, one of the things that just listening to you from the very first time we had a chance to go out, mm-hmm, and we were like walking and stuff, and then yesterday and today, especially hearing the stories today, because I was out there on the streets, mm-hmm, and it gets depressing, and you get in a rut,
yeah,
and you feel like nothing's going to change,
right,
even though you're trying to make things change,
yes,
and it just seems like everything is working against you.
Right.
What would be your message to somebody that's out there to just not give up?
There's one thing you can't lose is hope.
Right.
You know, there's always hope. You know, and just because you walk around and see the depressed state of your situation,
mm-hmm,
you can always come out of that.
Right.
Because there's always help and hope.
Right.
Never lose hope.
Never lose hope.
Yeah, because that's what that it'll get you through.
It'll definitely get you through.
It'll get you through, yeah. So, I can only speak from my own experience.
Right.
Yeah, so, you know, it's worked for me. And I'm sure just not losing hope would work for somebody else, too.
Right. Well, it definitely worked for me, holding on to my faith,
yeah,
and knowing that somehow I can get through.
Yeah, my religious background, yeah, my dad was a minister. Mm-hmm. So, my background kicked in a lot of times when I was in my addiction. You know, you don't have to live like this.
Right.
You know, it's a better way to live.
Right.
And the scriptures start popping up in my head.
Right.
I used to read the Bible every day. So I remember my young training came back,
mm-hmm,
and brought me back. Sometimes you have to become a little child again.
Right.
To really be actually born again.
Right.
And you know, to see that your life can get better because you get another chance to get a new life.
Right.
A
second chance.
Yeah, second chance. Yeah. Live two lives in one lifetime.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So you feel you've lived two lives in one lifetime?
Yes, I have, yeah.
So do you like the second time around?
The second time around is much better. not perfect, but okay.
But,
yeah.
But it's better than the first time around.
Better than before. I'm not, by no means perfect.
Right.
I'm not what I used to be. But I'm not what I should be today, but actually I'm not what I used to be either.
And that's what matters.
Yeah, so,
and you not
and
where you used to
every
be.
Day to be different, work
right.
on something. Yeah, you know, if I wrong somebody, apologize.
Mm-hmm.
If I, you know, do something that's not right, take a look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what did you do? If you know that wasn't right, or you need to look at that or check that. You know,
right.
You check yourself and you take it. Personal inventory.
Right.
Yeah.
So what's it like now? You have your own apartment, paying your own bills. What does that feel like?
Well,
coming from like your addiction, being on the streets, what does that feel like?
Yeah, it's a great feeling because after that time of being clean, I knew I was ready to do that because I had my own apartment.
Mm-hmm.
And then rent got too high, and then I was working, and I got sick and stopped working.
Mm-hmm.
I just got back into the homeless rut again.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't want to do drugs. I knew that.
Right.
So I said, I got to get off these streets. Because if I stay on these streets, it'd be too easy for me to get back in my old rut.
Right.
So I went to the shelter. I went to the help center. And then they sent me to the shelter.
Mm-hmm.
The shelter, I ended up in my new place right here.
Okay.
And if things went like clockwork, because in between time, my mom passed.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to go home to bury her. I had no money.
Mm-hmm.
I called a relative and they said, well, we can't go. We're sorry it happened, but we will send you. And I went on the train, and mm-hmm. it was a lovely experience. Mm-hmm. And I went to bury my mother, represent. Mm-hmm. I came back, was still home, because I didn't tell my younger brother and sister my situation, because it wasn't necessary at the time, because, mm-hmm. you know, I didn't need their help. So when I got back, I went to certain self-help places to get certain help that I get, food. And one place I went to, I told them I'd just come back and bury my mother. Mm-hmm. So they gave me a room for 3 days in a motel, mm-hmm. just so I could, like you said, somebody did for you, I'd be able to rest for three right. days and just grieve, mm-hmm. you know, in my own way, because I didn't come out for the whole 3 days. Mm-hmm. And then after I came out, I felt a little better, because I felt then that somebody else cared about me too. Mm-hmm. You know, you speak out about what's happened honestly, and people will help you. Because mm-hmm. I'm a firm believer that the Lord will always send somebody.
He'll always send somebody. Always
send somebody.
He'll I'm send somebody.
I heard old people when I was young to say that. But it was to my own experience that mm-hmm. I had to use it later and look back. I said, you know, that lady sure said that right. It was so true what she said. And we used to laugh the way she said it. But
we used to laugh the way she said it.
True. And that's part of my testimony. I'm a firm believer. Mm-hmm. The Lord will always send somebody.
Somebody. And it may not be what you want, but it's what you need.
It'll help you at the time.
It'll help you at the time.
Just what you need.
Just what you need.
Just what you need, yeah. And then by that time, you can get back to your own little routine.
Right.
You know, just with that little help. You know, just a little help. Yeah, okay. So that's where I'm at with that. And today it's better. Things are better. I have my own stuff. I have my mm-hmm. own food. I have my own place for my own kid. I go when I want, come back when I want. I go to my recovery meetings and support groups. Try to volunteer when I can. Mm-hmm. When I feel good. I don't feel good every day, but when I do, I try to be of service.
Okay.
So, you know,
so you try to like pay it forward.
Yeah. Okay. I try to do something. I have guys in here, my neighbors, I relate to. They know mm-hmm. they can call me anytime. Mm-hmm. Just like the old missionary, I get up and come, I get up and listen.
There you go. Suit up and show up.
Remember, somebody had to listen to me.
Right.
And somebody was there for me. So you never want to forget that.
You definitely, you never want to forget that. And that's something that I try to remember when I go out and do my outreaches. I try to remember of the people that did for me.
Yeah.
And I try to just like pay that forward. And sometimes it's hard when you're listening, because mm-hmm. you're... It's so hard to listen to people and not have a judgment for it.
Yeah.
But once you step out of self and just try to show up, mm-hmm. it's so much easier to help people. What do you think about the program that I do down here with you guys?
Well, I think this program, is out of all the programs I've experienced, it's a very good program, because it's more personal, because you have a smaller group of people and you're able to get people sometimes on a one-on-one.
Right.
And you find out the needs of people. See, sometimes people, big organizations, they want to do things as a whole, but right. they miss the individual.
Right.
So sometimes that person feels left out or... not for me,
right?
You know, but just sometimes for me, just the little small things is the one that count for me,
right?
You know, that I can be just happy just seeing somebody. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm so glad to see somebody again, because we're not promised another day.
We're not.
You know, we're not, so we get a chance to get to a group and then see somebody. Mm-hmm. It's good to see you, and I tell these guys, it's good to see them. We hug sometimes, and
yep.
it's how good it is to see you, because we're not promised.
Right.
Every day. You know, we get able to wake up in the morning. That's the day that the Lord is able to have. You know, he don't owe us that.
He don't.
So, you know, I'm grateful for your service, because you guys do not have to take the time out. You guys, you know, have your own agenda.
Mm-hmm.
And you go the other way. You mm-hmm. don't have to really be bothered with us, because, you know, many of us have our own agendas too, but mm-hmm. I believe that somebody's willing to come and help you. At least you can do at least stop. But then again, that's just me.
Right.
Know, everybody's not like me.
Right.
So I think it's wonderful.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, totally wonderful.
Well, Donald, I just want to say you are, and I've shared it with you before, and even more so today, you are a huge inspiration. And just sitting here listening to your story inspires me to just do whatever I can, as much as I can. Because you're right, tomorrow's not promised. And I would much rather somebody remember me for my works, not for tangible things that I collect.
Yes.
And my prayer is every day, God, move me into greater works.
Yes.
Into greater works, not into greater cars or houses and stuff like that, but into greater works. One thing you said at the beginning of the video was that you wanted to be an inspiration to somebody. You were a major inspiration, and I'm sure this video will touch a lot of people. So thank you very much.
Certainly hope so. Thank you very much for allowing me to do it too.
Okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks, Donald. All right. Bye.